In the vast universe, which spans 93 billion light years, is Earth truly the only place where life exists? Every night, the dark sky stretches before us, but it is not just an empty void. It is a system filled with undecoded signals yet to be unraveled. With more than 200 billion galaxies and trillions of planets estimated to exist in the universe, the probability that life exists only on Earth is almost zero. Modern science has launched a series of programs to search for biological signs and extraterrestrial technologies. Yet, to this day, the universe remains suspiciously silent. This leads to a controversial hypothesis. Are we being observed? In this video, we will analyze potential extraterrestrial civilizations, the possibility of advanced technologies, and the theory of the existence of entities beyond the human world. This is no longer a question of whether they exist, but where are they and what are they doing? Planets drifting in the vastness of space. Some lie in what astronomers call the habitable zone, an area around a star with temperatures suitable for liquid water to exist, a prerequisite for life as we know it. Names like Kepler 452b, Proxima Centauri b, or the TRAPPIST-1 system are no longer unfamiliar in the scientific community. These are planets with stable orbits around their stars, located in the Goldilocks zone, not too hot, not too cold. Kepler 452b, often called Earth 2, might even have a thick atmosphere and continents like ours. Proxima Centauri b is only 4.2 light years away, close enough for future spacecraft generations to potentially reach. However, what is worth noting is that intelligent life doesn't necessarily have to be like humans. On the contrary, it could exist under extreme conditions that we've never imagined. Imagine a civilization developing beneath the icy surface of Europa, one of Jupiter's moons, where underground oceans are hidden beneath layers of ice several kilometers thick. Or a life form capable of thought surviving in an atmosphere filled with methane, like on Titan, one of Saturn's moons. Perhaps in such a place, life doesn't need water, oxygen, or even light. If that civilization developed millions of years before us, their technology could surpass anything we have ever imagined. Space travel, quantum energy, brainwave communication, or even time travel. We cannot rule out the possibility that faint signals slipping through radar, unusual radiation bursts, or even strange optical phenomena observed might be their lingering traces. If extraterrestrial life exists, it might not be peaceful, but it could also be silently observing and waiting. If the universe is so vast and life is not exclusive to Earth, the next question is, where are they? This is the core of the Fermi Paradox, a simple but perplexing paradox that has puzzled scientists for decades. The universe is vast, old, and capable of supporting life, so why, to this day, is there no clear sign of their existence? A plausible reason: the distances between stars are too vast. Even with radio waves, which can travel at the speed of light, sending and receiving information between civilizations separated by hundreds or even thousands of light years is an almost impossible task. A simple hello could take 1,200 years to reach its destination, and another 1-200 years to receive a reply. But that's not all. Perhaps life tends to self-destruct. The more advanced a civilization becomes, the easier it is to trigger the buttons leading to its demise. Nuclear war, climate change, technology beyond control, or unethical and incomprehensible experiments. It's very likely that many civilizations existed but disappeared before they could even send a greeting. And a more terrifying hypothesis: they are out there, quietly listening. They have received our signals, radio waves, television broadcasts, radar signals from the 20th century, and have pinpointed our exact location. But instead of responding, they choose silence. Could it be that they are following some cosmic ethical rule, similar to the non-interference principle in science fiction? Or are they observing, assessing, waiting to intervene when the time is right? The silence of the universe is not necessarily evidence of emptiness. It could be the calm before the storm, or an unsolved message. Throughout the history of observing the universe, there have been moments that left more than just curiosity, they left an obsession. On August 15, 1977, the Big Ear Radio Telescope in Ohio, USA picked up a strong, clear, and unexplained signal from the Sagittarius constellation. The signal was detected by Dr. Jerry R. Amon, a volunteer astronomer with the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence Project at Ohio State University. The signal was recorded at 10:16 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time and lasted exactly 72 seconds, the maximum time the Big Ear telescope could observe a point in the sky as Earth rotated. The signal was much stronger than the usual background noise. On the data printout, the intensity of the signal was displayed by the sequence 6 equal J5. The U in this sequence corresponds to a value of about 30, which was the strongest intensity ever recorded by the telescope. So impressive was the signal that Dr. Amon circled this sequence and wrote "Wow" next to it. The frequency of the signal was near the hydrogen spectral line at 1420 mH. This frequency is considered a potential water frequency for communication between extraterrestrial civilizations, because hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe, and this frequency is less affected by natural sources of noise. Due to the design of the Big Ear telescope with two horns for signal reception, the exact location in the sky of the signal's origin couldn't be pinpointed precisely. However, it was determined to have come from the direction of the Sagittarius constellation. They didn't create shock waves when exceeding the speed of sound, they didn't emit clear heat signatures, and most bizarrely, they disappeared from radar in an instant, as if they could bend space. This is no longer the stuff of dreamers or forum speculation. This is official data confirmed by the military and included in investigations by the Pentagon's Advanced Aerospace Threat Identification Program. If these aren't human-made technologies, where are they from? These pieces of evidence, though fragmentary, paint a picture that cannot be ignored. We are not alone. And perhaps in the darkness behind the night sky, another intelligence has, is, or will be watching us. Suppose we are not alone and civilizations out there have existed or are still existing, then a troubling question arises. If they have vanished, what happened to them? And is humanity walking the same path? The universe is larger than we ever imagined, with 93 billion light years stretching across. The silence from space does not mean the absence of life. Perhaps we are alone, or perhaps we just don't have enough data and scientific knowledge to answer the question. There are signals, objects, and hypotheses that make humanity ask, are we just the latecomer in a universe where someone once reigned? Perhaps instead of asking, where are they, we should ask, are we ready to be found? Intrigued by the mysteries of extraterrestrial life and the future of humanity? Hit subscribe so you don't miss the next episode. And don't forget to leave a comment. Do you think we are alone, or are we being observed?